I'll just think about Parker. Parker, last time, she really didn't even attempt to answer any questions.
We're on our way to the girls' school to see how their little Quint testing went, and who knows what to expect this time.
I mean, there's no telling how meetings like this are gonna go.
I mean, I've always felt like Parker, like with her anxiety and stuff, has kind of always needed a sister in her class. But I wonder what it would be like if they're not together.
I mean, with Parker's anxiety, I mean, we do worry that the other kids just overshadow her in class.
Is it hurting her capability of learning? Is it making her behind? I don't know.
Guess we're about to find out.
How are y'all?
Can she just hang out up here?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll just be a few minutes. Hey, hey, hey.
Hey, come on in, guys.
We get big chairs today.
We get big chairs today. Yeah, I thought that through a little better.
All right,
guys, thank you so much for coming in. I'm really excited about all of them, but for very different reasons. But I want to start with Ava and Lulu. They have made huge progress.
Really?
Yes. On the first test here last time, one of them made a 48, one of them made a 40. They're now at 76 and 80, respectively.
Yeah.
They have doubled their score.
Wow. Yeah.
As we go into next year, I feel very confident in placing these two in upper rotation. Moving Riley out of their circle really allowed this to happen.
Yeah.
All right, now let's talk about Hazel Basil. Now, Hazel went from a 40 to a 60, so that's a little bit lower than I normally like to move into upper rotation, but I feel like a lot of Hazel's is the silliness. Mm-hmm. I think she decides she doesn't want to answer sometimes
yeah,
when I'm thinking.
She just wants to be cute.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know what letter that is? No? What about this one? You don't want to?
Yeah.
So I feel like this is not anything to worry about based on her maturity, how she acts, how she carries herself. So I feel very comfortable with promoting Hazel to upper rotation. I don't foresee any issue with that.
I mean, this is something that we've dealt with before when Hazel doesn't want to give straight answers at the eye doctor.
But I'm just proud of my little Hazel. She was the tiny one, has faced some obstacles with her vision, but that little girl will continue to rock through life.
Okay, Miss Riley. All right, here we go. She went from a 60 to a 96, from an 84 on test two to a 96 on test two, and then she's scoring a 24 in the reading part.
What about this one?
Green.
Green, very good.
That's crazy good. I don't even expect kids to get to this test until they have been in our kindergarten class. Now, she could stay in upper rotation.
And the girls, other girls would be coming in to meet her.
Right.
And then she'd be sharing a class
all
too.
All together.
Right. But my gut is telling me we need to move her up an entire grade level.
Oh boy.
So, I'd like to put her in our kindergarten level class. And I'm prepared to do that if you're prepared to do that, and I think she's prepared to do that.
I mean, this is something that we've put off thinking about since we put Riley in upper rotation pre-K.
I mean, she's gonna be a full-blown kindergartner now.
You know, most people hear that their kid is a genius and they're thrilled, but Riley, she's a special case.
Yeah, sometimes I'm worried that she's growing too fast, too quickly. I mean, she's only four, and she's still tiny.
So that's one thing we need to look at. So
I like really, Riley needs to come
Monday through Friday.
Yes.
Instead of
yes.
5 days a week means that Riley won't be doing family activities with us when the other Quints are on their days off. I mean, if it continues like this, that means Riley will be a whole grade level ahead of her sisters until she graduates high school. This is a lot.
So let's move on to Miss Parker. Now, with Parker, I want to talk to you a little bit more specifically about some patterns I'm seeing. I'm not going to lie to you, I do have some concerns. Now, with Parker, she didn't test much different than Hazel, but I know Hazel knows this stuff. I know that she does have that test anxiety, but she's showing a lot of growth. but academically, I have a little bit of reservation moving Parker up. If you notice, with her shapes and her colors, she's nailing it. She's got them. But she is struggling with her letters.
What letter is this? Do you know? All right, that's okay.
Now, obviously, kids peak and plateau at different times. She could just basically not be open yet to learning letters. And what I don't want to do is put her in upper rotation and then struggle.
That was going to be my next thing.
That's my concern. She internalizes,
yeah,
as we all know.
Yeah, she does.
I don't want her to think for a minute that she's not just as wonderful and bright as the others. I believe that if Parker for a moment thought that, that would snowball. And then this gap
it would be harder
between her and the other girls would grow because of that feeling.
Yeah.
I was mainly worried about her test anxiety for this round. But listening to Randy, seems like this could be more serious. It's kind of hard to hear, but she could really be falling behind.
Is there an option to, given if nothing changes, to keep her in low rotation?
Absolutely. Let's see how she progresses. Bring her in early August, and let's retest her.
Okay. I don't know what's worse. Parker moving up before she's ready and feeling inadequate? Or Parker staying in lower rotation a little while longer and realizing that her sisters have all moved up without her and seeing that she's in class with a bunch of kids younger.
So that's something I think we really need to discuss. You guys need to think about. I want you to weigh all the pros and cons.
All the decisions that we're making are just like so much more difficult because the girls are kind of separating themselves, you know, away from this like quintuplet bubble.
They're not really the Quints anymore. They're becoming individualized little children. Every choice that we make from here and now on is gonna create a ripple that's gonna affect them for the rest of their lives.
So no pressure at all.
Let me know by the end of the week because we need to make our class list and...
Interesting.